Today, we're going to talk about Drake. No, not that Drake. Francis Drake. No. Sir Francis Drake. Yes, that one. Sir Francis Drake was English explorer, slave trader, naval officer, an English hero, but for Spaniards, he was a pirate. They had a nickname for him, El Draque, or Drago, dragon, in reference to the dragon-like ferocity which they attributed to him. Very soon in his life, the Spanish became his lifelong enemy. One of his first journeys was in 1567 to Americas with his cousin John Hawkins, who was the captain. After almost a year of plundering and illegal trading, which included also slave trading, in the Spanish-American ports, Hawkins decided to anchor all his six ships in the port of San Juan de Ulua, present-day Veracruz, Mexico, for repair and resupply before the return voyage to England. While they were there, the annual Spanish flotilla of 13 great ships sailed into the harbor with the new Viceroy of Mexico, Don Martin Enriquez, on board. After a few days of negotiations, a pact was concluded by which the English were allowed to repair their ships and purchase ashore the supplies they needed, while the Spanish ships would anchor near them. Some sources mention that the peace was broken by the English by attacking unarmed merchant shipping, but others blame Don Martin Enriquez, saying that he ordered the pact to be broken. Nevertheless, a battle ensued. Only two out of six English ships made the escape. Drake was on one of them. For next 10 years, Drake was raiding Spanish shipping, attempting to capture a treasure shipment, attacking mule trains, and capturing tons of silver and gold. But that should be the story for some other time. Today, we're going to focus on his famous voyage around the world. In 1577, Elizabeth I of England chose Drake as the leader of an expedition intended to pass around South America through the Strait of Magellan and to explore the coast that lay beyond. Drake also had official approval to benefit himself and the Queen as well, as to cause the maximum damage to the Spaniards. The expedition was financed by Robert Dudley, Sir Francis Walsingham, Sir Christopher Hutton, Sir William Winter, John Hawkins, also Queen Elizabeth herself, and Drake himself participated with the sum of £1,000. After a couple minor setbacks, Drake sailed from Plymouth on December 13th aboard his famous ship Pelican, with few other ships and 164 men. The little fleet proceeded to the Cape Verde Islands, where they captured a Portuguese merchant ship Santa Maria, which they renamed to Mary, with its experienced captain Nuno da Silva. After passing the Strait of Magellan, he had only one ship left, the Pelican, which then he renamed to Golden Hind. The Golden Hind sailed north along the Pacific coast of South America, attacking Spanish ports and pillaging towns. In the Pacific, the Spaniards were physically and psychologically unprepared to resist the attack. Those shores had been exclusively in their hands for two generations, during which time they had spent little on defense. They were thrown into confusion and Drake seized immense treasure without much resistance. Drake sailed slowly along the coast of Chile, raiding the harbor of Valparaiso and seizing stores and gold there. On February the 15th, 1579, he arrived at Callao, the harbor of Lima, the Peruvian capital. This portion of the Spanish Empire was almost defenseless and the arrival of Drake caused panic and shock. Here he obtained news of a treasure ship which had sailed 12 days previously for Panama. Drake set out in hot pursuit and overtook the ship on March the 1st. It was the Nuestra Señora de la Concepción, variously nicknamed the Cacafuego or Cacaplata. Her sailors always called her Cacafuego or Cacafuego, which would translate into English as fire shitter. Her captain did not expect an enemy in those waters and mistook the Golden Hind for a friendly Spanish vessel. To his great dismay, he soon was Drake's prisoner. His ship proved to be Drake's richest plunder. Drake continued to sail north and eventually landed on the coast of California on June 1579. He stayed there some time, keeping friendly relations with the Coast Miwok natives. The land was claimed for the English crown and was called Nova Albion. It was the classical name for England, so called from the White Alba cliffs of Dover. On July 23rd, 1579, the Golden Hind began her voyage across the Pacific. On October the 16th, Drake sighted land in the Philippines and on November 3rd arrived at Ternate in the East Indies. Here he made a trade treaty with the Sultan and bought a cargo of clubs. On January the 9th, 1580, the Golden Hind struck a reef, but fortunately was able to slip off the next day and to sail onward first to Java and then across the Indian Ocean around the Cape of Good Hope and back to Plymouth on September 26th, 1580. In order not to antagonize King Philip, there was no public celebration of Drake's return. The enormous treasure he brought back was put under the safeguard in Plymouth. Drake quietly informed the Queen and the investors of the amount of profit which had been earned by the voyage. This has been stated to be £47 for each £1 invested, and enough for the English foreign debt to be paid off from the Queen's share of proceeds. On April the 4th, 1581, Elizabeth had Drake knighted on the occasion of a visit to the Golden Hind. In 1585, Anglo-Spanish War broke out when England joined the 80 Years' War on the side of the Dutch Protestant United Provinces who had declared their independence from Spain, and Drake sacked Santo Domingo, captured Cartagena de Indias, and St. Augustine in Florida. As vice admiral, he defeated the great Spanish armada that was attempting to invade England in 1588. Drake's voyages made huge impact on 16th century relations between Spain and England, and made the fight over monopoly on trade just more intense. That's all for now, thanks for watching.